Now then.
Deadly, 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 deadly. Deadly. Okay. Double check that. Okay. Us and our 20 skill points with nothing to attribute them towards. Oh well. All rise!
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results.
And just to let you know, we've still got new mechanics gonna be thrown at us for things.
If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate. Now then, where to begin?
We already know who did it.
Whoa, deja vu.
The one who killed Sakura is one of the people that hated her. Byakuya, Toko, or Hiro. It was one of you.
Again, that's not exactly an unsafe assumption.
Idiot.
I had nothing to do with it.
Yeah, I'd never kill someone, no way!
I don't want to hear your stupid excuses.
One bullet.
It was one of you. One of you killed Sakura.
And what reason do you have for saying so?
Because you all had a motive. You hated her!
Is that it? That doesn't make any sense.
That's the only reason you have for accusing us?
That's low. That's about as low as you can get.
Okay.
It was one of you. One of you killed Sakura.
And what reason do you have for saying so?
Because you all had a motive. You hated her.
Is that it? That doesn't make any sense.
That's the only reason you have for accusing us?
No, that's wrong. Another reason you suspect them is because Sakura wanted to meet with them, right?
Yeah, and that was right before she died. So there's no doubt about it. One of those three killed her.
So what do we got? The pocket trash.
The fact that Sakura wanted to meet with all three of them? There's no way that's not suspicious. One of you is absolutely guilty.
I don't deny that she wanted to meet with us, but I never went to see her.
I didn't either.
Yeah, same here. I never saw her.
Come on. There's no way none of you went. At least one of you is lying. The fact that Sakura wanted to meet with all three of them? There's no way that's not suspicious. One of you is absolutely guilty.
This is a pretty easy one.
I don't deny that she wanted to meet with us, but I never went to see her.
I didn't either.
Yeah, same here. I never...
No, that's wrong. Hiro, when we were talking before, you dropped a small piece of paper, remember? It was white with red polka dots.
What's that got to do with anything?
Everything.
Red polka dots? That's gotta be the wrapper from the candy I gave Sakura.
No, it's...
And the best thing about this whole chapter, Byakuya got slapped.
Ever since we got into the warehouse, I totally monopolized that entire box of candy. So there's no way a single one of them was left in the warehouse.
In that case, Hiro, where did you get that piece of candy?
From Sakura! It's the only explanation!
Well, I mean... Yeah, sure I got it from her, but... She gave it to me forever ago. It doesn't have anything to do with what happened to her.
Gee.
When did she give it to you?
The last time you saw Sakura was... when Hina had to go to the nurse's office, right?
Yeah, so I must have got it sometime before then.
Which was impossible.
Sure about that, Hiro. Hina didn't actually give Sakura the candy till after she left the nurse's office. So if that was the last time you saw her, there's no reason you should have had that candy.
Damn it! What I meant was...
Busted!
Oh, that's right! I did meet up with her in the rec room! You got a problem with that?
You really want to change your story to that?
Why the sudden hostility?
But we just talked, that's all! I didn't do anything, you gotta believe me!
You're acting incredibly suspicious.
You're acting incredibly suspicious!
More hostile.
It's not just normal hostility! You're the real culprit! I even have proof!
Really?
The proof? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about her shining message.
Really?
At the scene of the crime, she had written out Toko in her own blood, right? It was her dying message. Just like what you guys were talking about with Sayaka.
That's true. I saw it for myself.
See? See? Toko did it!
Something sound wrong there.
What are you saying? No way! I didn't do it!
You just don't know when you're beat, do ya?
Hiro, hold on. When did you see that dying message of hers?
Huh? Well, when we found Ogre's body. Duh.
But if you recall, Hina was very adamant about keeping you away from the scene of the crime. So it's hard to believe that's when you actually saw the message for yourself.
Kiyoko, you found the magazine on the magazine shelf, right?
That's right. Looking through the shelf, I found the magazine with the dying message on it. I found it right there at the scene of the crime, after we'd started the investigation.
If that's true, then what Hiro just said doesn't really make sense, does it?
Doesn't make sense? What doesn't make sense? Everything I said makes perfect sense!
Except you're forgetting one little thing.
Found the dying message when Ogre's body was discovered.
And I can tell you when I found the dying message. It was only after the investigation had begun. I found the magazine tucked away on the magazine shelf. When I pulled it out, I saw her final words.
What's your problem? What I said makes total sense.
Uh-huh. Yeah, where was the magazine?
I can tell you exactly when I found the dying message. When Ogre's body was discovered.
Ah, put up a second one on me.
The dying message. It was only after the investigation had begun. I found the magazine tucked away on the magazine shelf. When I pulled it out, I saw her final words.
What's your problem? What I said makes total sense. I can tell you exactly when I found the dying message. When Ogre's body was discovered.
Oh. That's why. No, I forgot to get the bullet back. That's what I called not getting... That's what I called not paying attention.
I can tell you, it was only after the invest... I found the magazine tucked away on the magazine shelf. When I pulled it out...
What's your problem? What I said makes total sense! I can tell you exactly when I found the dying message. When Ogre's body was discovered.
No, that's wrong. When Sakura's body was found, that magazine was sitting on the shelf nearby.
Yeah, you can speed up the individual sections of that if you really want to.
That's where Kiyoko found it, after we'd begun the investigation. And you weren't at the murder scene. So there's no way you could have seen it then. Tell us the truth, Hiro. When did you see the message?
Hold on! You're focusing on the wrong part! Why does it matter when I saw it?
Because...
All you gotta do is read the Vienna sausage Ogre left us, and we know who the killer is! Toko!
Read the what? Vienna sausage. What? I legitimately do not understand what he's going for there.
I don't even know where to begin with that one. He's just trying to confuse us.
Actually, can we even be sure Sakura wrote that message in the first place?
Yeah? I think we can all agree Ogre wrote that message. 100%, without a doubt, she wrote it. And this is me talking, so you know it's true.
Uh-huh.
Show me the proof. I'm at least 30% right. The occult is bullcrap. Give it a rest. I'm at least 30% right. The occult is bullcrap. The end is nigh. Show me the proof. I'm at least 30% right. The occult is bullcrap. Give it a rest. Show me the proof.
This should prove it. I'm completely unconvinced that Sakura wrote that dying message. Because if you look at it, the message was almost certainly written using a finger. But... both of her hands were completely free of blood.
Then, who did write it?
Who do you think?
Hiro could very well have written it himself. That would explain how he knew about the message in the first place.
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Ah! He admits it!
I figured as much.
But why would you write something like that?
Why else would you write something like that?
Because I killed her!
You. Okay.
Please, just let me explain what happened.
I got Ogre's note, and so I headed to the rec room right before noon, just like it said.
You just did exactly as the note asked? What a fool.
And when I got there... And that's all she said. After that, we just stood around in awkward silence. Suddenly, I heard her mutter something. As soon as I heard that, I just knew. I knew she was gonna try and kill me. She was gonna kill me and make her escape. So of course I freaked out, and then... my only chance. I grabbed the Monokuma bottle from the shelf and smashed it across her head. I hit her from behind before she had any idea what was happening.
So he panicked and smacked her upside the head with the bottle.
Then she just went limp. I didn't see her move again after that. Once it was over, I pulled myself together. I realized if I didn't do something, I'd be caught. Executed. So I wrote Toko's name in blood across a magazine on the table and I ran away.
I can't believe you! You're the worst! I hope you die!
Well, that's what happened. Go ahead. Roast me. Boil me. Do whatever you want.
However, does anyone else see a problem here? Any problem whatsoever? I mean, besides the meta fact that we just started this trial, and it's a little too early. He hit her once.
You're not gonna get off that easy.
Well, the locked room, sure, but, she had two head wounds.
It's death. Death for the one that killed Sakura. We're ready to vote now, right? We know who did it!
No, I think there's more to Hiro's story.
What are you talking about? What else could there be?
There's one thing that Hiro's story just now doesn't explain. And until we figure that part out, we can't consider the case closed.
Yeah, during the second time we investigated the rec room, Kirigiri pointed it out that she saw two head wounds.
I got it! That's true. Everything you just said. It doesn't explain why the magazine was hidden.
Doesn't explain that either, no.
By the time the body was discovered, the magazine had been picked up and put on the shelf. Why would you take the time to write that message, then stick it somewhere we might not find it?
Oh. Well, I didn't hide it. I'm sure I just left it sitting there on the table.
So yet more interesting little things popping up here.
Really?
He's lying! He's gotta be lying!
I don't see any reason he would lie now, after already confessing to the crime.
Then, he's not lying?
Assuming he's telling the truth, someone else must have put the magazine back on the shelf. In other words, at least one other person was in the rec room both before and after the incident.
I don't think there's any question about that.
But then, who was it?
If they went to the trouble of hiding the magazine, they must not have liked what was written on it.
I got it! It had to be Toko, right? Who else would want to hide the magazine other than the person whose name was written on it?
Is he right, Toko? Did you really go to the rec room? Why would I have... Wait, but more important,
that doesn't even matter. We already know who did it, right? Hiro just admitted it.
That's right. I killed her.
No, you didn't.
Blast you!
Don't doubt Hiro attacked Sakura with the bottle. But that's not where this case ends.
Yeah, we got a few other loose ends to tie up here.
What do you mean? What he means is that Hiro isn't the killer.
You can't be serious. That's just... I don't believe it.
Hiro, tell us what happened one more time. If we go through it once more, it should become clear he's not Sakura's killer.
So, what do you want me to do?
Just tell us what happened one more time when you attacked Sakura.
I don't really see why, but okay.
Time for the game to start being mean here.
I didn't want to, but I did it. I grabbed a Monokuma bottle from the shelf nearby. And I hit Ogre from behind, before she could do anything.
You hit her from behind. And you only hit her once, is that right?
Yeah, just once.
No, that's wrong! If Sakura died from Hiro's single blow, that doesn't explain why she had two head wounds.
Two?
That's right. She had two separate wounds on her head.
And remember, this girl examines dead bodies as a hobby. Personally, I'm inclined to believe her.
But I only hit her once. How could she have two wounds?
Two wounds means she was struck twice. What's more, both attacks must have come from a Monokuma bottle.
Hold on! How can you know that just from some cuts on her head? She was attacked twice with two Monokuma bottles?
Danganronpa. Ah!
It's not just...
That's kind of a scary thought.
It's also because of the Monokuma bottles themselves. There's something very suspicious about those bottles. Once you understand that point, you'll understand why two separate Monokuma bottles must have been used. Think back. After the incident, there were four Monokuma bottles left on the shelf, right? And we found pieces of a bottle on the ground, along with the chest piece it had inside.
That was the bottle Hiro hit Sakura with, right?
For now, just note that there were four intact bottles and one broken bottle. But originally, there were six bottles in total, meaning one has gone missing.
But how can you know for sure there were six bottles?
That's easy. If you look at what the bottles all had in common, it should become clear.
Time to play Hangman. But yeah, if you don't play chess, you're not going to get this puzzle. But if you do play chess, it's kind of obvious. Need an E, come on. Need another E.
Now I understand. That's it! The chess pieces! Inside each bottle, there was a Monokuma figure holding a different chess piece.
King, rook, bishop, pawn. I definitely remember seeing each of those.
And the piece that was inside the broken bottle we found was...
It was the knight.
The knight, if I remember.
So thus, we do not have a queen.
So, what's that matter?
I guess you don't know too much about chess, do you? Then let me explain. In chess, There are six different pieces. The king, the queen, the rook, knight, bishop, and pawn. What was left intact at the crime scene were the king, rook, bishop, and pawn. Just those four. And on the ground was the knight.
I will say this, the soundtrack for this game is really nice to listen to. Yeah, Masafumi Takeda is the guy who composed the soundtrack for Danganronpa. Go away, window.
Oh, so the queen is missing.
So we only have evidence for five bottles at the scene. Well, one apparently went missing.
What does Chess have to do with anything?
Yeah, Shogi is way better.
Not the point.
Yeah. Wait, no, that's not what I mean. So, let's say a bottle did go missing. There's still no evidence that has anything to do with this case.
Have you not been paying attention?
That bottle could have disappeared any time before the murder.
No. It's clear that the missing bottle is connected to this case.
How is it clear?
Think about what state the missing bottle must have been in. Maybe then you'll understand.
I got it! The bottle must have been broken.
What makes you so sure?
Because there was evidence at the scene that supports it.
Oh, there will be more arguments, yeah.
Huh?
That's right. We found evidence that shows there was more than just one broken bottle at the scene.
And what is this evidence?
I got it! Earlier, Kiyoko and I did a little experiment. We compared the weight of the broken bottle pieces at the scene. And what we found was that the collection of pieces was heavier. And the reason for that is... there was actually more than one bottle's worth of shattered glass.
So from this, we can surmise that two bottles were actually broken at the scene of the crime. But someone did their best to clean up the pieces of one of the bottles, along with the figure inside.
Oh hey, it is a new name. I'm sorry, I was kind of paying more attention to the game. Hello there, Baritone Blur. Did not make a note because my colors are all the same for names. Go figure.
But when they did, they must have left behind a few too many pieces. Which is only natural. They certainly had no way to measure the exact right number of pieces to remove.
But why would they have to try and get rid of it like that anyway?
Because of what it would reveal about the case.
Ah.
The bottle that was removed from the scene was used the second time Sakura was attacked.
Oh, come on. Don't do that again. Stop it. Freaking hell.
The second wound on Sakura's head came from that second bottle.
Non-blind playthroughs are boring, huh? Okay.
Given all the evidence, this is the only possible conclusion.
The killer wanted to make it look like there was only one attack, so they had to get rid of their evidence.
Yeah, I can imagine watching it blind is one thing, but playing it blind would be kind of you'd be wandering around and looking at everything and really stretching things way, way out.
From there, we can conclude that it wasn't Hiro who delivered that second blow. Wouldn't you agree, Toko? And there's the matter of the magazine. You must have been in the rec room when the incident took place.
Wait! I admit, maybe there was a second attack, but... but there's no evidence I had anything to do with it!
There's not?
No way! You killed her! I'm sure of it!
I'm sure you switched awfully fast.
Shut up! Until 2 seconds ago, you were claiming you killed her!
I'm not afraid to admit when I'm wrong. That's just the kind of guy I am.
Again, shut up!
Plus, I just remembered something that proves it!
Oh?
Okay, fine. Let's hear it.
It was right after I got Ogre's note. I was kind of nervous about it, so I went to the rec room early. You know, to stake it out or whatever. So I was waiting there, and that's when I saw her. I saw Toko go into the rec room! Pretty soon, Ogre showed up, and she went into the rec room! I assumed Toko was still in there, so I figured everything would be okay. That's why I headed in. But when I got inside, Ogre was all alone. Toko had disappeared.
And you just now decided to share that with us?
After the shock of thinking I'd killed someone, I forgot all about it.
Could someone tighten the screws on his brain? I think they've come loose.
I think they're missing altogether, but point.
So, Toko, where the heck did you disappear to?
You don't know what you're talking about. I never went in the rec room.
I'm sure she didn't disappear, but maybe she found somewhere to hide.
What? Hiding in the rec room? Don't be ridiculous. Why are you all ganging up on me? You're all nothing but...
You're not helping. Not helping your case at all. So yeah, even in Chapter 4, we are still getting new elements added to these freaking battles here. The bullet time battle now has something completely new in it, which is loads of fun to deal with. Yeah, the final strike, after you whittle down all their argumenting and stuff and get them to stop just shouting at you and get them to say something you can refute, now we're going to have multiple choices. Yeah, just like for the normal battles, now we get extra truth bullets for the bullet time battles. So even after everything you go through with all the reloading, shooting down thing, you still gotta pick the right truth bullet to break the their argument. And yeah, we are about halfway through the game. Just now. Come on, there it is.
This should prove it.
You have plenty of time. Don't get me wrong. You have plenty of time to flip through everything.
Did you know someone left a handprint behind on the inside of the locker?
And the proper execution for the final strike. Man, it's been a while since I've looked at the second game mechanics. I don't recall that. Was that the little swords clash thing where you have to keep bouncing back and forth? It has been a while.
They must have been hiding in there and put their hand on the wall without thinking.
Yeah, you were a fangirl of all the characters that end up dying. This is not... And I'm not poking fun at you for it, it's just... Am I going to play the second game? Yeah. Yeah. The third game, I don't know if I'll be able to play because they need to port it to PC. But if they get the third game ported, I will probably play that one too. But yeah, we'll be playing the second game after. Oh yeah, that. Yeah, that is a little better. Yes.
Does this handprint look familiar, Toko?
It doesn't.
Okay then, let's just compare it to your hand, shall we? That'll clear everything up, right?
Stop wasting my time. Just tell us the truth.
Okay, it's my handprint.
That... Wow.
Dang, she just straight up admitted it.
Just straight up... Yep, mine.
Then you killed Sakura! No, I swear, there's no way!
Out with it.
I probably did kill her.
Wow.
Straight up again!
Wait, what do you mean, probably?
Give us the details, Toko. What happened between you and Sakura?
Talk. Now.
After I read Sakura's note, I decided to go there early, so I went into the rec room. I didn't know what she might do if I didn't go, but I was too scared to face her head on. So I figured I'd just sneak in first and hide in the locker.
Then, did you see what happened? Did you see me hit her?
Yes, and I saw you write my name. I saw you forge her dying message.
Well, that's awkward.
So after he left, I jumped out of the locker.
Please tell me we're not talking about fetishes in the chat.
And put the magazine back on the shelf.
But when you did, you put it back upside down.
I didn't mean to. I was in a hurry.
Imbeciles, all of you.
Forget all that. Why did you attack Sakura?
After I put the magazine back, I heard a sound behind me like a monster growling. And when I turned around... there was Sakura, covered in blood. Staring right at me!
The next line should be, and I wet myself. Good God, look at that face.
When I saw that blood, I fainted. Right there in front of the magazines. I don't remember what happened after that. If you want to know more, you'll have to ask her.
Why was I laughing? No reason. How does she control her sneezing like this?
Guess it's back.
It was your fault after all.
My fault, Master's fault. When our faults combine, they soar to even greater heights.
Just answer the question. Did you kill Sakura?
Well, to be honest, Miss Morose and me don't actually share our memories. So I can't really say what was going on. But I was just minding my own business, sleeping peacefully when someone shook me awake. Was it a prince paying me a visit? I wondered. So I opened my eyes to see.
Yeah, but they belch. Is something you can force on yourself with relative ease. Hold a little air and burp, no big deal. But a sneeze is something, you know, at least a true sneeze, it seems like what she needs to come out and play, so to speak, but seemed to be a little bit less able to be forced. Face again.
Everywhere! I was not prepared for that. And, well, I guess it took me by surprise. I got so startled, I smacked her with the first thing I could find, which I guess was a bottle. Sakura was just worried about you, and you're terrible! No, she's terrible! Thanks to her, I murdered someone who wasn't an adorable boy for the first time ever!
That's the real tragedy in all this.
And when it was all over, you collected the pieces of the bottle to get rid of the evidence, didn't you?
I wasn't about to die for some woman! If I'm gonna go down, I want it to be for killing Master!
Just go away and die your meaningless death alone. Don't drag me into it.
You still being you, Tagami.
But I just can't catch a break, you know? Fate's got it out for me. Because normally, Sakura should have been able to dodge my attack, no problem!
Even as strong as she is, she must have still been reeling from Hiro's attack.
Hey, come on! That's... you know... But anyway, I'm not the one that killed Ogre! So that's good!
Well then, that's that! Let's start the boat! What's wrong? Everyone, we're ready to vote, right? Let's do this.
We're not ready to vote?
No, not quite yet.
Not yet? Why not yet?
Don't you think there was something odd about Toko's story? I mean, you had to have noticed.
Odd? Huh?
Hiro's attack.
Several things.
But that still wasn't the end of it. Tell us your story one more time. Tell us what happened after you fainted. Then even this gaggle of idiots should understand what I'm talking about.
You wish it my command, darling!
Surprised when you saw Ogre covered in blood. So you smashed her head in with a Monokuma bottle?
You got it! I smashed her good!
And where did the attack take place?
Right where I woke up! I killed her there in front of the shell!
No, it's wrong! We found Sakura sitting upright in a chair. If the blow by the shelf was the cause of death, there's no explanation why she was in that chair.
So, you finally noticed.
That's just another lie from a bloodthirsty serial killer!
Are you sure you didn't attack her while she was sitting in the chair?
No, I'm sure she's telling the truth. Anyone who saw the murder scene should think the same way.
And yeah, this is fairly obvious.
I got it!
Sakura was definitely attacked in front of the shelf. The blood stain by the magazines is proof of that.
Then she must have moved the body after she killed her, right? All to make it look like I did it! Because when I hit her, she was sitting in the chair!
And yeah, this... there is some spectacular voice work that's actually going on right there.
Hey, come on now.
With Genocide Jill here.
Heavier than my own scissors. There's no way I can move a muscle-bound heavyweight like that.
Then what's the deal?
Well, are you still convinced the case has come to an end?
Plus, the biggest mystery of all, the locked room. Still has yet to be explained. Until we take care of that, we can't say this case has been properly settled.
Oh, that part's easy. After she killed Sakura, Toko just hid in the locker again.
Really?
Ooh. So she just hid in there till everyone showed up and opened the door?
At the funny thing is, we kind of already talked about that.
And while everything was all confused and hectic, she just snuck out of the locker into the group.
No, I don't think that's possible. I got it! Even before we opened the door to the rec room, Hina and I both got a look inside. And at that point, the locker was already open. So obviously, Toko couldn't have been hiding in there.
Okay then, where was she hiding?
I don't know! What's this whole locked room thing about anyway?
How do you not know? You killed her!
I have no idea what was censored.
I think the fact that I don't know proves I didn't kill her, thank you very much. You're lying!
No, she's not. I've been saying all along, there's still more to this case.
But if Genocide Jill didn't do it, that means Ogre didn't die from the shot to the head!
And?
Well, I can't imagine what else could have killed her.
That's because you're overlooking vital information.
So let's see what has talked about things.
What was it that killed Ogre?
That has.
If it wasn't from Genocide Jill's attack, then what was it?
There's no other possible cause. What killed Sakura? I can't think of anything other than the shot to her head.
No, that's wrong. According to the Monokuma file, Sakura had vomited blood.
Yeah, I may have to go in after this stream and check the settings on my censorship.
I think we can assume there's a chance this was related to her cause of death. In fact, there was even a trace of blood left around her mouth.
Well, I mean, maybe when she got hit with the bottle, she cut the inside of her mouth.
If that's all it was, the file wouldn't have specified vomited blood. Not to mention, I didn't find any cuts inside her mouth.
Need a chicken there? God, you really are into dead bodies!
No, I'm not into dead bodies. What I'm into is solving mysteries.
But if there wasn't a cut or anything, then what made her vomit blood?
Good question.
Some sort of reaction within her body. Most likely, Sakura was poisoned.